problem involving pattern loading, a pasteboard exam. Hi, hello, welcome back to Gillesania Engineering Videos, your daily supply of solutions to engineering problems. If you like what you see, please subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified every time we upload new videos. Alright, in this problem, we will discuss a problem that involves pattern loading. So this is a pasteboard exam, and this was given, I think, 3 times or 4 times already in the board exam. Okay, so here is the problem. Okay, this is the given figure. The beam ABC in the figure shown is simply supported at A and B. So it was clearly stated that simply supported at A and B. The beam will support a total load of dead load of 6 kN per meter and a live load of 4 kN per meter. L1 is 9 meters, L2 is 3 meters, and H is 5 meters. We are given the properties of the beam section. We have here the moment of inertia, the area, depth, and so on and so forth. Okay, we also have the weight of the beam. But the problem says a total dead load. So, well, this means that the 6 kN per meter here should already include the weight of the beam. Okay, otherwise it could have been stated here a superimposed dead load. Okay, now the first question. If the full length of the beam is loaded, what is the maximum bending stress? What is meant by that? The full length of the beam is loaded. Loaded with what? Okay. The second question, what is the maximum bending stress considering possible load pattern? Possible load pattern. And the third part, what is the maximum maximum possible average shearing stress or shear stress in the beam? Okay. So, something's sounds like unfamiliar, no? The full length of the beam is loaded. Maximum bending stress considering possible pattern. Well, to give you a background, you know, the loads are dead and live. Dead load and live load. The dead load, of course, these are the weight of the all the fixed members, fixed structures attached to this beam. So, yun yung including its own weight. And the dead load is always there. The dead load is always there. Whether it is being in use or not in use, then there is that's always acting on the structure. But the live load may be applied on the full length or part of the length only. Okay, so that's the idea. Bakit sinabi ditong if the full length of the load of the beam is loaded? So, meaning in part 1, the full length of the beam is loaded with live load. Because the dead load is always acting, whether it is being used or not. No? So, there is always the dead load. But the live load may act or may not act depending on the condition. So, the full length of the beam meaning the full length is loaded with live load. And number 2, considering possible pattern of live load. Considering possible live load pattern. Okay? So, I hope that makes sense, no? So, the full length of the beam, the part 1, the full length of the beam is loaded with live load. Now, part 2, considering possible live load pattern. Because live load can only act. By the way, the topic or the issue here or the topic talaga is the beam only. Oh, we will not consider the column. Okay? So, considering possible live load pattern on the beam. So, when you say live load pattern, the live load can act all throughout as in part 1 or only on the overhang part or only on this AB. And part 3, the maximum possible average shear. Okay, let us check on that. So, this is the given loads. The total dead load, this must include already the beam weight. And then the total live load is 4 kilonewtons per meter. Okay, let's consider the first part. The full length of the beam is loaded. So we have the dead load is always acting. That's always present. Okay, the full length meaning the full length of the beam is loaded with live load. So this is the case. So meaning the total load on the beam, dead and live, is 10. Okay, 6 for the dead, 4 for the live, that is 10 kilonewtons per meter. So the question is the maximum bending stress caused by these loads. Alright, so let's compute the maximum bending moment. So unahin natin yung reaction. Summation of moment about A0, then we can solve for RB. Alright, so we have RB, then summation of forces vertical 0, then we can solve for RA. Okay, I'll just make this fast. I know you can follow this one. Okay, so for us to know where the maximum moment is, let's draw the shear diagram. The shear diagram will look like this. So the shear at C is 0. Then we will go down by a value of 10 times 3. So that's negative 30. Then we will go up by 80. So that will be positive 50. And then we will go down by 9 times 10 or 90. That will become negative 40. Okay, so this is your shear diagram. So you notice here that there are two possible positions for maximum moments. That is at B and somewhere here. Okay, so this point, to locate this point, you can use ratio and proportion, or simply you can just divide the shear 50 by the load of 10. 50 divided by 10 is 5. This is it. And this is 40. This the shear is 40 divided by the uniform load 10. This should be 4. Alright? So the areas of the shear diagram are negative, this is negative 45, 1 half 3 times 30. 1 half 5 times 50 is equal to positive 125. And 1 half 4 times 40 is negative 80. So the moment diagram can now be drawn this way. So this is negative 45, and this is negative 45 plus 125, that's positive 80, and you have here 0. Okay? So nakita natin that the maximum bending moment is 80. So ito yung gagamitin natin to compute the maximum bending stress. Okay? Ganun siya. Huh? So the maximum bending stress is MC over I. Your IX is 1.6 times 10 raised to 8. This is the moment na gagamitin natin, yung 80. And then your C, of course, is kalahati nung D. So that will be yan. So the answer is 87.5 megapascal. So that is letter A. Okay. Okay, next. Part 2. Tabi natin yung diagram natin. Okay, what is the maximum bending stress considering possible live load pattern? Now, the question is this already the maximum stress na considering pattern? No? So, here, the pattern is the full live load applied to both spans. Now, let's consider another pattern because this is very critical because positive moment will occur if you alternate the live load. No? Okay, what if the live load is only applied within AB? This is it. Ganun lang. So, this is the 6, the dead load, and the live load is 4. So this loading becomes like this. Ayan. So 6 and 10. Now let's investigate this beam. What will be the forces, internal forces in the beam, the maximum, no? Shear and moment caused by this loading. So again, we will compute the reaction. Okay, reaction muna. Hatiin natin to into uniform rectangular loading of 6 and an additional of 4 here. So summation of moment about A0, then you can solve the value of RB. Okay, you can follow that one. Your RB is 66 kilonewtons. Then summation of forces vertical 0, then makukuha natin yung ating RA. RA can now be solved. Okay, so that's it. Ayan. So, just like what we did here, let's draw the shear diagram and the moment diagram. The shear diagram will be, so the shear at C is 0. Then we will go down 6 by 3, that is negative 18. Then we will go up by 66, so positive 48. And we will go down by 90, that will be negative 42. This is it. Alright? Then the point of zero shear here between AB will be 48 divided by 10, that's 4.8. By the way, the area of this is 27. This is 4.8, so the area, and this will be 4.2 divided by 10, 42 divided by 10, I mean, that's 4.2. So the area of this is 1 half 48 times 4.8 is 115.2, and the area of this is 88.2, negative. Alright, then the moment diagram will look like this. Just making it fast, okay? So this will be negative 27 here, and this will be negative 27 plus 115.2 is positive 88.2 kilonewton meter. Okay, now let's compare the diagrams, the loading. Okay, that's it. Now we can see here, this is the diagrams wherein the live load is applied all throughout and the diagram with the live load only on AB. We see that the maximum shear is what? 45, 30, 50. This is the maximum shear. That's the maximum possible shear, considering possible live load pattern. And the maximum moment naman is not 80. It's this one, 88.2. See that? Yan, maximum moment. Okay, so this will be the moment na gagamitin natin in part 2. And this will be the shear na gagamitin natin in part 3. Okay, so this is this problem all about. Pattern loading. Alright, for the maximum bending moment, we have MC over I. The moment is 88.2. Your I is the same yung kanina. And then yung C natin naman is kalahati ng 350. So the answer is 96.47. Alright? So I hope you got the point here na hindi porke applied lahat ang live load, malaki yung magiging value ng moment. Take note of this. This is always the case. If you are up there for the maximum positive moment, you alternate the live load. Arrange it alternately. That will cause a big positive moment. But if you want a big negative moment, apply the live load all throughout. Also shear. Maximum shear is will occur when the live load is applied all throughout. Only the maximum moment and some reactions may actually. Again, if you notice, no, if you're up there for the maximum reaction at A, considering possible live load pattern, mas malaki yung reaction sa A when the live load is only applied at AB rather than the live load is applied all throughout. Look here, the reaction here is only 40. But this is 42. No? So, ganun yan. Effect of the live load pattern. And finally, the average shearing stress is average lang. So, V over DTW yan. Shear divided by DTW. D is the overall depth and TW is the web thickness. So, your V is 50 kilonewtons and then DTW and the answer is 17.86 megapascals. Okay, so that's it. I hope you learned a lot from this very short tutorial regarding problem involving pattern loading. And this is a past board exam. Sana makatulong to sa preparation nyo sa board exam. So thank you so much for watching and I hope you learned a lot. So please click like our video and share naman. Pakishare naman to sa iba, ha? And then don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified every time we have new videos. Okay? Thank you so much for watching.